What's up, guys? It's 7:16 a.m. I'm being a little quiet because my parents are still asleep, but let's start a full day of eating. I'm excited to be back, and this is pretty much what I've been eating on my mini cut. I'll hop on, I have a treadmill in the basement, and I'm gonna do that for 30 minutes. I just do like a heart rate of 135 about. I usually watch like Netflix or Hulu in the process, and then afterwards I'm gonna shower, make my breakfast, and show you guys that. Look how bougie my cats live. Every morning, they get fresh shrimp as a treat. Living large. All right, guys, so cardio is done. I'm gonna hop in the shower quickly, get ready, and then I'm gonna show you my pre-workout and breakfast, meal one of the day. Okay, so the oatmeal is already done. I put it in, so I do 30 minutes of cardio, so about 20 minutes in, I'll go put the oatmeal in the microwave and then let it sit for a little bit. So while that is cooking, we're starting our eggs. So pretty much I eat oats and eggs for breakfast, the most typical thing. I start by putting in the mushrooms, lay out all my ingredients, and let's do this. And then also, so pretty much as I make my breakfast, I also make my post-workout meal, which I will show you after. So as you can see, my eggs are pretty much done. And I got a coffee going, and then I have my oatmeal still sitting. Okay guys, so this is my breakfast part one, because I like to eat my protein first. I like to watch Vikings while I eat my breakfast. It's a really good show. So it's 200 grams of egg whites, coffee, my greens, and a bit of sugar-free ketchup. So that in itself, my whole breakfast, this is the macros right here. It's, and I'm gonna tell you the measurements for everything right here as well. Okay, so this is part two of my breakfast, which is the oats and the blueberries. And pretty much all, the majority of my carbs are pre and post workout right now, and then the rest of the day it's just like veggies. So I'm definitely gonna enjoy this. Okay, so I finished up eating my breakfast, so now I'm making my post workout meal to bring with me to the gym. So as I was eating, I had my rice in the rice cooker, and I like to cook my tilapia like in bulk, so I had some tilapia left. I only cook though for like 3 days max, because fish goes bad quickly. So this is, I literally cooked this yesterday, so it's still good to eat. So we have 6.2 ounces of tilapia, 50 grams of baby spinach, and I put 75 grams raw of jasmine rice. And honestly, I don't even know how much that equates to cooked, because carbs hold water, so I like to weigh them uncooked, because it's way more accurate that way. So I'm gonna just put the rice in the bowl, and then I'm gonna put 10 grams of this MCT oil in it, because it's a medium chain triglyceride, and those are amazing post-workout, really helps drive the carbs and the protein for recovery. And I do about 3-4 grams of salt per meal. Not 4 grams of sodium, but 4 grams of salt. So be careful with my wording. And I just put some sugar-free ketchup on it again, like 20 grams. It's probably 5 calories max. And a pickle, because I like my pickles pre and post-workout. And that's gonna be my post-workout meal. Here are the macros, and let's keep going throughout the day. All right, man, I don't know if you can see, but I have sweat dripping down my face right now. So I literally bring my post-workout meal with me in the car. Now, I already showed it to you, but I'll show it to you one more time, because I love you guys. Even though I feel like I'm about to pass out and just want to eat, I'm going to show you because I care. Sorry. I got my pickle, right? I have this little handy-dandy part of the bowl. And we got my rice, my tilapia, MCT oil, and some sugar-free ketchup and some baby spinach underneath, and some garlic powder and onion powder. Here are the macros for my post-workout meal. I bring it with me because I train about 2 hours, and I eat an hour before my workout, so it's really dark. I don't know why.
Let's try and fix this. So yeah, I bring my meal with me because pretty much by the time I work out, it's already been 3 hours, so that's exactly when I want to eat. So I'm gonna dig in and enjoy this and watch some Netflix on my phone in my car in the scorching heat. Gotta love it. All right, guys, time to dig in. All right, what's up, guys? So I got home, I washed myself, and right now we're making some chicken on the grill. I like to make it with charcoal. It just tastes so good like that. I've been making all my chicken like this pretty much every day. I am shirtless. I just do this so I can tan while I cook. That's literally it. But yeah, I'm really excited. I will show you my meal three. I'm on 5 meals right now. My off season, I'm on 6. My reasoning for that is if I go down to 5 meals, I can eat more in each meal. So I'd rather do that and I just space it out a little more in between, like, you know, throughout the day. Right now I'm eating every 3 hours about. My off season is like every 2.5 hours. 2 hours. So yeah.
Okay, guys, so the chicken is done and I have some tilapia cooking out outside, and this should last me about, like, honestly 3 days max. I eat a lot of chicken. Even when I'm dieting, I'm on 40 grams per meal right now, so that's a bunch.
Okay, so we finished up the tilapia too. This is gonna be, I pretty much, like I said, I eat this post-workout pretty much every day with my jasmine rice. I just really like the combo. With jasmine rice, I either like tilapia or like a lean beef. It's really, really good. And now I'm gonna make my meal number three, which is only 20 grams of carbs, and I'm gonna show you my carb of choice at the moment for this meal.
Okay, so this is my carb of choice for this meal. It's called lavash bread. And if you look at the nutrition of it, it's literally 60 grams for 32, which is half a flatbread. I eat a whole one. So as you can see, it's 8 grams of carbs, 1.5 grams of fat, and 6 grams of protein. So I eat pretty much a whole one, so a whole flatbread. And then I'm gonna show you the rest of the meal when it's all done. Okay, so here's my meal number three. We have 140 grams of of chicken breast, 20 grams of tzatziki sauce, some baby spinach, just put some salt and soy sauce on the baby spinach. And this is the lavash bread. I just toasted a little bit, and I put 50 grams of guac on it. And I'm gonna put the macros right here. Oh, I also have a black coffee. I know it's in a glass, sue me. But this is my meal with the last pretty much carbs I get for the day.
What's up, guys? So right now I'm actually editing a transformation video that's gonna be out before this one. So if you haven't watched that yet, make sure you do. I'm probably gonna leave a link to it at the end of this video. But right now, this is my next meal. If you can see it, we have 2 cups of zucchini. It's like focusing on my face, but it's 2 cups of zucchini and 180 grams of beef sirloin. I like to try and get a beef meal in if I can. And 28 grams of tzatziki sauce. And here are the macros for this meal. And I'm gonna go in and dig in. So this is my fourth meal of the day. Pretty much just trace carbs from the zucchini. No carbs at this point in the day.
All right, what is up, guys? So it's actually the next day. I'm showing you my last meal of the day. Sorry, like, pretty much totally forgot to record it. I actually just finished editing the transformation video. You guys are gonna really like that. It's really good. Make sure to watch that if you haven't yet. So I keep looking at my viewfinder. I need to, like, get used to doing this. But I want to show you in depth how I make my protein ice cream, because I've actually changed my recipe since I posted it on Instagram. So this is, again, not something I created. I'm not taking credit for it. I just want to show you the way I personally make it. And I think it tastes really good. So I'm going to take you step by step through it. All right. So you're going to need protein powder. I use my cookies and cream by NutriBio. I'm not sponsored, I just really like the taste of this. You're gonna need pink Himalayan salt. Yes, it is that important. And I want it pink Himalayan. I don't want, like, I don't know, anything else. No iodized white salt, just pink Himalayan salt. It just, something about the taste of it really will bring out the flavor of the protein powder and everything else we add to it. Blender, obviously. Now, I use these two things. I'm gonna use the vanilla stevia by Sweetleaf. And I know this one's, like, pretty much empty, but I have one in my cabinets that's more full. I'm gonna use a sugar-free Vermont butter syrup. You are going to need egg whites. So the egg whites and the guar gum are gonna pretty much act to, like, thicken up the ice cream. And the key for this, guys, is to make sure there's a lot more ice than water and liquid, because that's gonna, like, thicken it up a lot and make it, like, less of, like, a shake and more like ice cream. You're gonna take your scale. Now, for me personally, I'm going for 40 grams of protein and 11 grams of fat per meal. So for me to get that, it's gonna be 30, ooh, oh my God, okay. It's gonna be 34 grams of whey. Now, you know, everyone works with their coaches differently. The way me and my coach work are by macros. So I don't do it if it fits your macros, but we have certain macros I wanna hit for the day. So sometimes you get like, you know, instead of 35, I get 34. I don't like to round, I like to be right on the spot. So that's why sometimes you get some like random weird numbers for my meals, if that makes sense. So 70 grams of egg whites. And even though I'm not getting ready for a show, guys, I like to weigh everything out year round. I just believe in creating constant habits. It's much easier to just do it year round than stop and go back to and stop. So that's just how I am. So the egg whites, then for Himalayan salt, I do 4 grams. I weigh it too. And again, you're gonna think, why am I adding salt to something sweet? But I'm telling you guys, it really makes or breaks it. It's gonna actually bring out like the sweetness in it. It's like unbelievable. So for the guar gum, it really depends how thick you want it. I do 3 grams of guar gum. You can do 1, you can do 2. I would definitely not do 4. I've noticed I've tried 4 and I like got such a bad stomach ache. So 3 is kind of like the sweet spot for me, where it really thickens it up, but I'm not like bloating and having stomach cramps and stuff. And you're gonna see, guys, like when I'm done with this, it's a lot of volume. So this is great when you're dieting and if you're starving, and if you're someone like me that can eat a lot, it'll fill you up. And you know, before bed, having a nice full stomach is definitely something at least I enjoy. So yeah. And then for the almond butter, we're doing 20 grams of almond butter. I don't like doing actual full like peanuts or almonds, because it's just like not a lot of bang for your buck. It's like literally it'll be like 5 almonds and it'll be like, you know, sick. It's just so much, it's so calorie dense. Like with at least the butter, you can get like 20 grams, which is, in my opinion, quite a bit. And it's not that much from a caloric perspective in comparison to the actual nuts. Am I making sense right now? Anyway. Okay, so I'm at 19, so it's good enough. With the spoon to make it 20. Now, I'm gonna go to my fridge and add just a little bit of water to this.
Ice. So as you can see in this whole thing of ice, like I literally have barely any water in it. Okay guys, like that's what I'm talking about. Like barely any water, you do not need a lot. So then I'm gonna put the cap on. I'm warning you right now, this is about to be like really loud, and I'm sorry. And we're gonna start it, walk away for a couple minutes, and then I will show you the finished product when it's done. It's been like 5, like you gotta let the guar gum really like do its thing. So it's been sitting here for a while, and look how much that rose, guys. Like this is a lot. Now if this is too much for you, then obviously you can just use less of everything and then you'll get less. But personally, I just like to taste it and see if it's completely blended. Look how cool it is. So, and everyone like judges me for my baby spoon, but guys, like ever since prep, I've been using a baby spoon because I eat really fast. So it just kind of like slows me down so I don't have indigestion, honestly. So I just take a bigger spoon. I think I'm pretty comfortable in front of a camera, that's never my problem. But it's more like angling of the camera. And then I'm just gonna top it off with the syrup. And that is my last meal of the day. Here are the macros for it, and bon appetit. And I'm gonna end the video here, guys. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, subscribe, leave a comment. What do you guys wanna see next? Make sure to watch my other videos, and see you guys.